this close tie with the people. This is the secret of the success of the Chinese Communist Party. It's remained, it kept its vitality and remained ever young.
She was born in China 100 years ago, and some 30 years later, China became her permanent home. As a communist and an anthropologist, Isabel Krug has observed China's transformation under the leadership of the Communist Party of China for over 70 years. Isabel and her husband David came to China in late 1947. Their book, 10 Mile In, documents the fundamental social changes brought about by the CPC's initial land reforms.
My parents, Isabel and David Krug, went to a village called 10 Mile In. They were interested in the developments in the countryside, especially under the communists.
Do you still remember 10 Mile In?
Sharpen up your thinking,
eh? Yes. You were living there for 3 months before it all began.
I was very courageous.
In order to set up a new China, a new society, they needed to take power, and giving the farmers their own land, this was the best incentive for the farmers to support. The basic aspiration of the communists was a more equitable society, because people like the landlords, who just owned property and didn't do any work, that was regarded as exploitation. So there was real poverty. I think after her study, came to the conclusion that the land reform was the single most important factor in winning the support of the rural population.
These footages show how farmers joined the People's Liberation Army after the land reform. The CPC's policy won the support of the rural population. The Liaoshan, Pingjin, and Huaihai campaigns of late 1948 and early 1949 were decisive battles of the Chinese Civil War. The CPC defeated the Kuomintang, who were better equipped and outnumbered them.
They knew that it was the eve of nationwide victory of the Chinese Communist Party and set up the new China.
To consolidate his power, one of the first things the CPC did after new China was established was to keep up with the land reform. The 1950 land reform law abolished the system of the feudal exploitation by the landlord class. In its place was a system of land ownership by the farmers.
There was a new situation. There was peace in China, and the small holdings of the farmers kept productivity very low, so they were able to introduce cooperatives, which helped to have the build the scale of production, and through the establishment of collectives, they were able to undertake infrastructure development. So they kept adapting. I think that's the secret of the vitality of the Chinese Communist Party.
Xiaogang Village in Fengyang County, in East China's Anhui Province, was the pioneer in the new household responsibility contract system. Its bold farmers sealed a secret and illegal deal to divide communal farmland into individual plots. Grain output then skyrocketed. Soon, the CPC approved Xiaogang's innovation, saying poverty is not socialism. This ushered in a nationwide rural reform to raise productivity and farmers' incomes.
My mother has seen the CPC at work since the 1940s. She has been most impressed by their close connection with the people, their reliance on the people, and of course their dedication to the welfare of the people, which is the entire point of the Communist Party.
40 years on, land reform continues to be a priority for the CPC. Over 600 kilometers south of Xiaogang, in Yujiang County of Jiangxi Province, a new round of reforms has been carried out since 2015. The abandoned illegal houses are part of the reform. Yujiang is one of 15 pilot counties. Yujiang's party official, Xiong Zhilong, took us to see how they work. Today they're demolishing the last illegal houses in Luopingshan. Xiong Zhilong stressed all demolition should be voluntary. That's why it takes so long. Xiong Zhilong told us villagers have come to realize the real benefits of returning the occupied land. Across China, there are at least 70 million such houses in rural areas taking a large amount of construction land. Xiong Zhilong said most villages used to be empty, overgrown lots. Young people left to work in the cities. Putting the idle land to use is key to vitalize the countryside. It works in concert with rural land transfer.
这个中央的土地流转政策，对农村的规模化经营有什么意义呢？
可以促进我们农业产业能够由高质向高效发展。通过土地流转实现规模化经营，就是使我们的土地的这个利用率这个更高。今后的发展趋势，我认为就应该是这种情况。
您在这做这个生意做了多久了？
我们是2015年，到这里来投资的。那么这个地方比较范围比较广的连片的一块山地，那么整个产业它是从种苗、种植、加工一体化的这么一个新兴产业。
像我们那个农村进行土地流转以后，我们希望这个土地它用于什么呢？
我们希望这个就是土地流转给我们像王总这样的有技术，然后又能够引进这样好的品种的这样的一个新型经营主体。老百姓土地流转金是有了，老百姓将自己的劳动力释放出来，还可以在他这个产业园务工。
用这个土地流转政策对您的这个事业的最大的好处是什么？
我呢可以规模化经营，它关键的规模化经营以后能够托起一个新兴产业。
The experiment in Yujiang reflects the party's determination to reduce the wealth gap. The CPC understands addressing people's needs is key to winning and keeping their support.
This close tie with the people, this is the essential ingredient, really. This is the secret of the success of the Chinese Communist Party. The situation has changed a lot now. The vehicles for social economic development may be different. The methods, many of them continue to be the same.
盖堡村与外界啊是不能隔绝的一种状态，所以它贫困程度比较高，就达到1/5的贫困程度，交通不便，这些产业啊就很少，所以这个脱贫任务是非常的重。其实我们的这些老百姓啊都很勤奋，他从5-6点钟有的爬起来就耕田了，耕到晚上才回家。看着他们特别辛苦，但是又挣不到钱，我就想到了要转变大家的观念，告别只是靠种庄稼，来脱贫这样的想法。这个15秒的啊。我是来自贵州省黔东南苗族侗族自治州黎平县盖堡村的第一书记，我叫吴玉胜。我就听到了一个神话故事，就说我们这里的非常动听的这个侗族琵琶歌啊，它是天上的七仙女下凡到我们当地，就传给了我们侗族姑娘，它是有这样一个神话故事。所以我就想把这个我们侗族的文化和这个神话故事有机结合。所以我们就想到了这个用侗家七仙女啊作为形象大使的宣传，一定要通过网络自媒体的力量。想不到就是困难是远远超过我的预期的。
我父母是很反对的，因为那时候刚对这个都不熟，以为他们是传销骗子嘛。
父老乡亲看的话感觉就说闲话嘛，
就我也接到通知可能就要被调回原单位了，就是大家说你不务正业。
说我们也是不务正业的七仙女。
其实特别困难的时候我是真的心里面落泪了，但是没有落泪，所以我觉得我必须坚持下来可能才取得这个胜利。因为我放弃了，我觉得村民他就很长一段时间可能就无法转变观念。
2019年时候是这边有发生泥石流，那个黄浆都叫不出去嘛，然后当时那个村民挺多房价都烂在地里了，然后我们当时就靠直播卖出了挺多小黄浆了。
后面的我们做得越来越好了，村民也开始慢慢的理解，也比较热情了，现在也比较支持。
吴玉胜 took us to see one live streaming by the Seven Fairies. He says 109 households in Gaibao have shaken off poverty since he became the first secretary in 2018.
但是未来接续乡村振兴呢，我们想继续通过直播让大家知道 快消失了这种农耕文化，我们还在坚守，而且一直会坚守下去，然后带火我们这里的旅游业。
这边的朋友 ，Hello。
街头民工监督政策啊，对于老百姓而言啊，他们这个和党啊，就是关系更近了。通过街头民工监督啊，这农民，我们这个下村的共产党员啊，都和他们达成一片了，所以他们觉得其实党就在自己身边，就在群众中。
China launched the world's largest ever anti-poverty campaign in 2012.The CPC's goal was a moderately prosperous society called Xiao Kang. The concept goes back 2,500 years ago. Today it means no one will need to worry about basics such as food, clothing and education. The deadline was the end of 2020. That's a full decade ahead of the UN's goal for eliminating absolute poverty. The plan came from the party's top leadership.The whole party was mobilized. Party secretaries and governors of 22 provinces and regions in western and central China signed a commitment to combat poverty. By the end of 2020, nearly 100 million Chinese had been removed from extreme poverty. For the CPC, it was about keeping its word to the people.
China has been a leader in this work, the greatest anti-poverty accomplishment in history.
Wu Yusheng was one among the millions of party members to answer the call. He won the support of villagers in his three-year term.
这个他们直播以后对于你有帮助吗？
啊，那肯定有哦。
帮助我们这个对外宣传，对吧？
他们觉得你蛮有网红潜质嘞。
这个你看，我这个头发不想的。
让我们老人家来表演一个才艺。
父母亲还是不理解，就是花了十多二十年培养你读书，就是走出大山，现在你主动又申请又回到了大山。但是对于我而言呢，我觉得之前的大山和现在的大山是不一样的。之前的大山大家都是想逃离的一个地方，所以现在的大山其实是大有可为的一个大山。从来没想过后悔这个词。就从开始啊决心做这个时候，其实就往着忘我的境界去做这个事情了。其实我们在投民工监路上啊，很多次都和师生是擦肩而过的，因为他这里特别险要。我经常看到很多我们投民工监在一线的战友啊牺牲的消息，就每次听到这些消息啊都很沉重。特别像黄文秀啊这些优秀的党员干部啊，觉得好可惜。所以有时候他们也是我们就是坚持战斗的动力啊。
This footage was filmed by Huang Wenxiu, first secretary of Baini Village in Guangxi Zhuang Autonomous Region. On that rainy night, she was caught in a flood on her way back to the village. She died shortly after shooting this video.She was just 30 years old. Huang Wenxiu spent some 400 days in Baini village, which was one of the poorest in the region. The villagers say they will always remember her.
这是一张临时会议桌，这张照片就是文秀书记在驻村召集我们开会的一个照片。这也是文秀书记在驻村的时候他的驻村日记，然后他为了更好的掌握贫困群众情况，因为他就自己把每个屯的群众的居住情况画在他笔记本里面。这地图上的所写的名字是代表着这一户的户主，有的户主的名字上打有点。这是就是标明建党立卡贫困户，这也就是文秀书记在这里驻村的时候他的请示，群众都不愿意让任何人来动，都说文秀还没有离开我们，他还会一直照顾着我们百里村。这是驻村书记的统一的驻村服装，群众大家都一看到就知道是我们村里的第一书记。
Huang Wenxiu's own family shook off poverty in 2016.It was the same year she finished graduate school in Beijing. she decided to return to her hometown to work in poverty alleviation.
她为什么要加入中国共产党呢？
因为就是没有想到生命有价值，比钱高，钱多没有价值高。
她就是跟您交流过她的想法。
她就是说，我们能够走上祖大山，感谢党，所以她才有家国情怀。当天她，我必须要为落叶先生的雨季洪水的时候，怕老百姓出大问题，是给自己地出力嘛，不设想就不行。只要看他的日记，看他好像就是他的工作人员，我能看得见了，摸得着了。而且他某些地方还超过我的想象。
最让你感觉佩服的是，
把他的事业工作能够给人民群众深切感受到共产党的啊，我看到他写这一句，他写这句话出来，我就流泪了，超过我的想象。如果他没有这句话，也做不出来这种。
These are rare footages of Huang Wenxiu in Baini.
乡村振兴关键在青年，希望大家多多关注农村发展，多多支持农村工作。
Wenxiu is gone.But she still lives in the hearts of many.
秀，我们大家都很想你。又是一年的清明节，我们带着家人来看望他。
如果他当时不选择这条道路的话，他的命运可能是另一种。
我想，因为他的有一个坚定的信念，所以他会奋不顾身，甚至。没有考虑到个人的安危。
您记忆当中他说的最多的是什么？
能够真真正的让乡亲们能够早日脱贫。他是一个有理想、信念坚定的人，所以他会把他的个人的理想融入到党和国家的理想和追求当中。
Some 1,800 people have given their lives in China's war on poverty. By 2020, over 3 million village first secretaries and officials have been stationed in poor villages to work alongside the locals. Zhou Changzhan says one of the gifts Wenxiu has left to the village is this road.
Because we all think that we live in the big mountains, the road is not connected. Our road was in the end of 2019.修好的，文秀书记他并没有看到我们的路修好的样子。这条路，群众很感恩文秀，群众都把我们这条产业路叫做文秀产业路。我现在看到的这一片绿油油的这个沙糖皮啊、水果还有山上这些产业，都是带领着腊肉屯的群众共同发展起来的。在2017年的时候，这里的产量才5万斤，然后到2019年和2020年，一年都差不多100万斤。群众都觉得他把自己的生命都付出去了，那我们作为百姓的群众，还有什么理由不去发展好自己的产业？
The mountains now yield a special gold for the villagers.
每年到夏天的时候才能收。
Farmer Bantu Mao says life has never been as sweet as today. He has planted over some 5 hectares of orange trees.
你看。像我们这里这个山里面呢，半山有了雾，经常有了雾的话，但是，有这个水分要充足。在文秀书记没来之前，我们是光长树没有果，但从他来了以后，帮我们解决了从植树解决了植树上的难题啊，从外县请来了植树人员。
现在村民们经常想念他吗？
特别是每年到收果的时候，我们有收成的时候，大家都很想念他。
我是听着两栖霸王花的名号，然后来到我们这里，全年都在一个备战的一个状态。 抵近侦察、武装渗透、攀登、格斗、以及伞降、潜水各类武器的操作使用。
加油！别拍！加油！别拍！加油！别拍！加油！别拍！加油！别拍！加油！别拍！
黝黑的脸庞，沾满泥土的迷彩，风雪加风沙，酸甜加苦辣，南海水的辣咸，东南风的严寒，这便是陆战女兵的生活。
和南城队员同样的训练科目，同样的训练内容。
三个针。
我们严玲排长从一名普通的女孩子，经过几年的锻炼，现在成为一名女特战队员的佼佼者。
报数，一二三。
她能体现出一种女特战队员特有的这种精神面貌。
首先，严格训练场秩序，做到令行禁止。希望同志们利用好游猎天际，把本次课训练搞好，为下午实战化训练打下坚实基础。大家有没有信心？
有有有！
她是我们女兵中的骄傲。
因为自己选的路，我想着就是怎么的爬着要爬着走完。
其实刚开始的时候，我们对女特战队员的加入是持一定怀疑态度的。
以前人家都会说啊、女子不如男啊什么的。
我们怀疑他们能不能像我们一样能吃苦。
尤其是作为一个女兵的话更不容易，更何况是作为一个女特战队员来说。
但通过时间的推移，女特战队员他们所展现出的一种同样不服输、不甘落后的精神，是值得我们骄傲的。
我也是希望就是说他们能从陆战队员身上看到我们女性不一样的勇气。
战争是不分性别的，随着女特战队员的不断加入，我们也可以发现
女陆战队员她不是花瓶，
女特战队员的加入也是一种机会的平等。
我们女性可以承担的东西会有很多，就是一个观念的问题而已。
Yan Ling's idea is widely accepted today, but it hasn't been easy to overcome thousands of years of patriarchal tradition. Michael Crook recounts how the CPC broke with the old way of thinking.
Sometimes the women would have their own group meetings and discuss what they heard. Before the communists came along, women were generally never consulted. Women were not involved. But here, you see, these are women.
Yeah.
And the women, when they have meetings, this woman is spinning and they've got their children with them. So they're doing work and meeting. In traditional yeah. Chinese thinking, women should stay at home and not get involved in public affairs. Women are supposed to obey their father when they're young, their husband when they're married, and their son when they are widowed. But this, they changed all that.
So it was a real change.
Yes. They wanted the women to be liberated and speak out for themselves and not answerable to the men. The system was not successful when the men were insisting that the women leaders should be model wives and model daughters-in-law. No.
The founding of New China in 1949 meant the new ideas could be put into law. The first law the new government issued was the marriage law. It granted women freedom of marriage and freedom in marriage and freedom of divorce.
这是新式婚姻，未婚夫妇到市政府登记，亲戚和朋友们迎接着幸福的新郎和新娘。
Chinese women are more than wives and mothers. As in war, they were involved in building new China. In many industries, women worked alongside men. Some became iconic images of the time. In 1950, the CPC started the first of three massive literacy campaigns. They included special classes for women to enable them to participate in society. On International Women's Day in 1952, The People's Republic's first group of female pilots flew across the skies of Beijing. In 1955, Chairman Mao Zedong proclaimed, "Women hold up half the sky." Ever since, it has served as an inspiration to create a level playing field for women in Chinese society.
Zuojiang 训练主要是在反恐特战小队在突入敌占房屋时所采用的一种训练。
更实际用于房间的突入，比如说这个人质被俘虏，更多的是一个小组之间的配合，每一个人他有不一样的任务和使命。
我们主要采用我们的手语，就是要体现出我们一个快、稳、准。通过这种训练来培养我们特战队员特别能吃苦、特别能战斗、特别能忍耐的精神。
Yan Ling proves herself in training every day to be ready for anything. She's one soldier in the fight for equal representation for all Chinese.Wang Guizhen was a farmer in rural Shanghai. In the late 1960s, she was a barefoot doctor, considered by many to be the first. Wang and other community healthcare workers were often barefoot, working in the paddy field. Wang says they brought the most basic medical care when the country was young and poor. For Wang,The Barefoot Doctor campaign symbolized the success of China's healthcare strategy. She was proud the WHO used it as one model for public health.
在接受了治疗以后，他恢复了健康，这都是他的子女，这是他的爱人。在党的这个带领下，咱们把血吸虫给消灭了。
Across the country, village doctors like Wang Guizhen dramatically improved access to healthcare in rural communities for a few decades. The CPC made the best use of the limited resources.An invisible enemy attacked Wuhan. Dr. Liu Qingchuan, the medical department chief at Hankou Hospital, was on the front line from the very beginning. Luce Hospital was one of the first three designated to treat the anno pneumonia. It would later be called COVID-19. The Wuhan health authorities knew information was crucial.
We
Soon, the true nature of the virus was determined. China shared its findings with the WHO, laying the foundation for global vaccine development. Xi Jinping, General Secretary of the CPC Central Committee, called for resolute efforts to curb the spread of the virus. He said the top priority is the safety and health of the people. A dozen hospitals, including Hankou, were converted into COVID-specific facilities. Containment was a test for Wuhan. The party decided to deploy medical workers from outside. One was Dr. Wu Jianfeng, an ICU specialist from Guangdong in southern China.
He said, 再迟两天, 他们都要崩溃了, 真的要崩溃了, 对吧? 就是我们, 但是一接手, 这个病人进来, 走进来, 啪, 就倒在地上了, 就是我们连抢救的这个时间都没有给我们。
China promised free treatment to everyone infected. Resources continue to pour into Wuhan. The entire country stepped up. Wuhan built two emergency hospitals. Huoshenshan, with 1,000 beds, was completed in 10 days. Leishenshan, with 1,600 beds, was completed in 12. The city also set up 16 temporary hospitals, treating over 12,000 patients. At the same time, the mainland's 31 provinces and regions coordinated a public health emergency response.
因为你救治的它不是一个个人的一个个体的问题了，它已经影响了整个的经济的、文化的、社会的各个方面了。救人、救国、救世。
39 million party members went to the front line. Nearly 400 of them died on duty.
There's no question that China's bold approach to the rapid spread of this new respiratory pathogen has changed the course of what was a rapidly escalating and continues to be deadly epidemic.
人民至上，生命至上。
Victory was bittersweet. Time for Dr. Wu Jianfeng and his team to say goodbye. And after 100 days in the battle zone, Dr. Lu Qingchuan could finally go home. Lu Qingchuan says he did what a party member should. The campaign in Wuhan was crucial in the global war against the pandemic. Ban Tongmao says the biggest legacy Huang Wenxiu has left behind is the confidence in a better life, that everyone shares the fruits of development.
乡村治理，然后。
熊志龙 can clearly see the results of land use reform.
那未来中国农村的未来的面貌会什么样呢？
未来中国的农村的面貌，我觉得是跟城市的差距会越来越小。
全面建成小康社会，一个也不能少。
I'm sure and I hope that the Communist Party of China will continue to rely on the people.
这个洗心洗意为什么我不是一句空话要一时之引都补出来。
革命信念就像我们永不老的誓言一样的。
加入共产党无怨无悔。
And I wish it to remain so forever.
The CPC has set the target of a beautiful countryside and well of farmers by 2050. From land reform to health care, from gender equality to eliminating poverty, the CPC says this is howIt puts the people first.
一艘小小航船划破黑暗，从雾霭沉沉到红日高扬，我是熊熊火焰照亮前路，是万千青年燃烧的信念。我是钢铁意志，征服困难，从泥鳅蜜饯到盖地欢天，一棵百年大树扎根泥土，它枝繁叶茂，它青春不老。我是坚实臂膀，把你托起，在殿堂之上，在天更两旁。你想问我是谁？我就是你，我在你心上，你在我心间。之中汗滴如土，用满头青丝换绿叶无边，悠悠青山之上
不获全胜绝不收兵，
匆忙用花样年华换万种欢颜。我是坚
这个现代再不时代，我们的现代化企业就会被上市。
在殿堂之上，在天更两旁，你想问我是谁？我是你，我在你心上，你在我心间。
人民最美好生活的向往就是我们的奋斗目标。
把你托起，在殿堂之上，在天更两旁，你想问
我是愿者如梭，
我就是你，我在你心上，你在我心间。我在你心上，你在我心间。